Yeah, kamikaze, rising ballers, ballers only, the next wave, Oakland on the beat. Topping slapper, defender or attacker, but you know it don't matter, cause man do both like Saka. Tryna get that contract, get that dough, rising ballers, let man know, come like Trent when the text on show. Top boy shooter, come like Brewster, Joe Gomez beat Bully and Bruiser. Squad goals make the team go further, to Maury to Mount to Timo Werner. Jadon Sancho, man a hot stepper, bring the young guns through Arteta, and we don't drop the ball like Kepa. Man get clamped and man get twined, and Diags, yeah they get sprayed. Told man straight is ballers only, us man are coming with the next wave. Man get clamped and man get twined, and Diags, yeah they get sprayed. Told man straight is ballers only, us man are coming with the next wave. Bang, 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 bang. Ballers only. Concrete to the pitches, rags to riches. Rising ballers, ballers only. Yeah, come on, bow.
Yes guys, the Gaffer Maz, Rising Ballers and StatSports partnership is officially back. You saw what we done last time, so now I've got four new players. There are some new features on the Pro Scores app. You can measure yourself against Harry Kane, Phil Foden, or even see your scores. The Pro Score is made up of five metrics, all right, for speed and distance. Is calculated over the best 8 out of 20 sessions. So, you've seen the reaction from the pro players about the FIFA cards, then you've got the Pro Score app. I know which one I'll try, all right, and I'll bravo. So make sure you get that StatSports vest on, you get that Apex tracker on, and you get to work. As well as that, I am looking for the best scores on the app, all right? If you impress me, you're coming to trial with Rising Ballers.
Abdullah and Mitch.
Yes, yes.
We're here at the home of grassroots football, Hackney Marshes.
Yes, yes.
Obviously, you man played here before?
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. When I was younger, we used to play here for school games.
Secondary school, innit? Yeah.
Yeah, but yeah.
Good memories here?
Yeah, good memories, I can't lie.
I can't lie, we didn't have good memories, innit? In our school, I can't lie, we kept losing, but their school, they were the best.
Good, couple so. Bangers here still. Yeah. Can't lie.
Those of you that don't know, Mitch is from StatSports.
Come on, man. Hey.
This is. They scored a lot of goals.
Couple bangers, I can't lie.
I don't know about that one.
Yeah, Kingston, Kingston,
he's good, dad, dad!
Alright, obviously, we're playing against Priory Park Rangers today.
Yeah.
It's going to be a tough game, obviously, a small pitch suits them. What are you thinking ahead of the game?
Obviously, because small pitch, we're going to have to move it. Yeah, can't do no dilly dallies.
At the back.
So hopefully we'll try to put the game to bed early doors, and yeah.
Just enjoy the game.
Yeah, just enjoy the game, literally.
Obviously, Mitch, you've been playing out of position, but you've been doing
a
solid job, bro. I found a new position for you.
Can I say, what can I say?
Well, I saw you got Man of the Match at South End.
Yeah, I did still. Yeah. Right,
one last thing, prediction,
I don't want to jinx it though, man.
8-0, RB.
8-0?
8-0.
I don't want to jinx it, but I'm looking at a 10.
Me Marshes. I personally love Hackney Marshes, being from East London myself, but you played on Hackney Marshes before?
I played the international tournament years ago, a grassroots international tournament. It was a charity fundraiser. Yeah, it was quite fun. It was me and the boys put a team together. We actually lost in the final that day, but good memories here, man. It was obviously better weather, and from what I can see, better pitches as well, because the pitch we're playing on today is a bit meaty, but it's the home of grassroots. So you can't really complain, you can't moan about it. You know, it's putting all these people out, you know, kicking ball and etc. It's just another game for us, we just got to get over the line. This game today, we got to treat it like tournament football, man. Can't be pretty today. Literally, the pitch is tiny. So Kevin and the defenders are going to have a few instructions. I'm not going to say pump it long, direct, Stoke City, but yeah, we're going to have to change up our game slightly. But apart from that, you know, we're playing Priory Park Rangers. They've got a mixed results so far at the start of the season. You know, we came off a very hard-fought 1-0 win last week against OIR in the Cup, which done the boys a lot of confidence. So yeah, man, it's time to, you know, kick on again, get 3 points, climb up the table, because, you know, we need points on the board now.
Because the team that are top of the league at the moment, they've got 11 goals ahead of us. 11. And that's what it's going to come down to. Because they beat us at our home ground. We're going to beat them when they're away, all right? But it's going to come down to goal difference. So make sure when we play an opposition like this, we show them the respect, like any other team, but we put the ball in the back of the net. Everyone understood?
Daniel Berry, back at RB. He's only 17. How old are you now?
18.
He's a year older, but that's my still wearing number 17. You're back, bro. Excited?
I'm excited to be back, yeah.
How's football been treating you?
Good. Came back off an injury, but football been treating me good, yeah. Happy to be back.
Well, are you going to get a goal and an assist today? What's the fans going to see?
Goals.
Yes?
Yeah, goals and even assists as well.
Jeez. If you don't, obviously, all you old RB fans, you know who Daniel Berry is. Give us a quick score prediction down below.
I'm going 6-0 RB.
6-0 RB? And how many goals for you? I'm saying a hat-trick.
Maybe a hat-trick, yeah.
That's what we like to hear. Have a good game. This is Bilal, man of the match last game. I'm telling you right now, yeah, I'm calling it. I'm like a sensei. You're going to score from like here. I pointed. There's the goal. He's going to score from here. And he's going to score a banger. How many goals? See that touch?
Today, I'm going to let the boys have fun today.
Yeah?
It's me. You get me? Let the boys have fun. Give them a couple of goals.
All right, quick score prediction.
Oh, I'm going to say 8-9-0.
I feel confident, you know. Last game was very hard. Scored the last 2 minutes, but I think defensively it was 10 out of 10. So another tough game today against a physical side on a small pitch. So it will test us physically, but confident that we get the win today.
You cannot go in life where you want to go if you don't start at the bottom. All right, this is the home of football. This is what they call it, grassroots. All right, we've all played on these pitches. We know how difficult they are, all right? We're now just at a luxury where we've got a nice home pitch and we play at some decent away pitches, majority of the time. This is a time now where we've got to play on a bad pitch, but we show people we can still play on a bad pitch, okay? Because if you can play on a bad pitch, well, how do you play on a good pitch? Even better, you're flying, you're flying. So today when I said inside the change room, it's about tournament football. It's tournament mode in my mindset. So those of you that have played some games, I know because that's where I picked up a few of you from, where matches are only 30 minutes long and you're fighting for a 1-2-0 game. That's how that first half is going to be. That's that intensity that we're going to have. We are going to win the game in the first 30 minutes. 2-3-0s, all right? We're not going to let them settle. They've had a very long warm-up. They're already leggy as it is. We're young, we're fresh, we're vibrant. Yes, we're technical. Yes, we're flary. But that agenda is not on today. Today is about being ugly, getting 3 points, going home. Simple as. And then we can enjoy our home game next week.
Yes, guys, it's your boy LB. Today, unfortunately, we haven't got T1 due to other commitments, but we're still going to make it work. Today, we've got Rising Ballers versus Priory Park Rangers in a league game. Let's see how the boys get on, man. From last week, we want to improve on that. In the second half performance, we do want to do better overall and get the win today. Between the sticks, we've got Kevin. Right centre back, we've got Jeffrey. Centre back, we've got Hamdan, aka No Ham, No Dan, aka Go Ham or Go Home. We've got Kelvin, left centre back. The two protecting them, we've got Bumi and Tom. Ahead of them, we've got Abdullah, Bilal, and Steve. And a front two of Yusuf and Daniel Berry. On the bench, we've got Yunus, Amin, and Trey. Let's get into this game and hopefully RB can get the win. Number 11 looks ready for the game, doing the Goku jump, but you've got PPR kicking off in the dark blue. We've got RB in the light blue, infamous light blue. Looking for a win today as number 11 does skip past, but he skipped another clip. Kevin's had a bit of a wobble wobble there. Oh, that's nasty. Can't record that one. Unlucky, mate. You play on, though. We've got the ball in the air. Yusuf contesting for that. We're trying to get forward. 23 pressures on him, but he does turn. Does he get fouled there? He doesn't. We've got Amin on the ball. Playing it in. We've got Abdullah. He's going to go for the cross. Of course he will. Back sticks. Did we get it under control? Can we pull the trigger? That's 1-0 to the RB. First attack. Bit of pressure. Good intention, and that's a great return for Daniel Berry, to be fair to him. Missing for the squad for a minute, but he's back with a bang. That's great control to skip past the defender and just pull it across goal. Great finish, 1-0 to the RB. A massive change that you can see from RB between now and pre-season is that the players do press with an intensity. There's a lot of intensity. There's that want to win, and we are going for the win today. Is he going to play wide to Abdullah? He won't pull the trigger instead. Keeper parries it instead of keeping that one on the pitch, and it goes out for a Rising Ballers corner. New face for the camera, we've got Steve here, it's a friend of Yusuf's. Rumours say they got a green link, and Yusuf does prove that. Great chemistry, good link up, that's a great cross, and a great attack ended from Yusuf. That's 2-0 to the RB. PPR really need to sort themselves out because we really don't want to have another one of those games. But overall, RB are playing well, we're putting the pressure on, and we're making things happen, man. Number two, setting the ball back. Does he get tackled? He tries to turn. Is he going to win it? No, of course he won't. We got RB on the attack. Yusuf making a run. Charging down the line. Is he going to square it? Will he pick his head up? No, he won't. Daniel will go for the shot instead. Some say, you know, T1's not here, but I'll say it for him. Some say he should have passed that, but you will never know. Calvin takes the throw in. PPR scrambling to get it clear. Yusuf looking for the setback. The ball's all over the place. He pulls the trigger. Unfortunately, it does go over there. Yeah. RB piling on the pressure. Daniel Berry pressing. Yusuf pressing. The keepers mumbled that one. Made a mess of that, but they've pinged it across their own box. Rule number one for all you centre backs and some fullbacks especially. Guys, that's rule number one in defending. When in doubt, clear it out. All my defenders know that one. That's a great setback, but the pass isn't great. In the air, is anyone going to come and claim it? Troy's going to claim it. He's driving at the defender on his left foot. That's a great effort from him, to be fair. Great strike. Keeper should do better there, but the power was the difference between the keeper saving it and him getting it gone. That's 3-0 to the RB. This is a great response. Considering last week what happened, we really don't want that to happen again. We've seen the comments about the attitude of some of the players and we've come to rectify that. As we've got PPR on the ball, trying to make something happen, trying to get back in the game. Three flicks into midfield. Great half-time from 13 to say it on. He's going to look wide. He will look wide. Getting pressed, though. Will he make the right decision? 23's made an absolute mare of that. Is he going to get pressed out? No, he doesn't. He does well to get the ball clear. 14 playing into midfield. Flick on. He's done well there. 11 will pull the trigger. It's gone just over the bar. Should think about that one, number 11. Some say he could have set it forward. He could have made the attack happen. Boom, he's setting it forward. He's going to square it. He will square it. We've got Tom on the ball right now. Is he going to pick his head up? He's going to pull the trigger. In fact, he won't. Skips past the diving defender. Gets caught late there. Is the ref going to pull it back? He does indeed. Some say he should be booked there. That's a rash tackle from him. RB just setting up for the free kick. We know we've got shooters. Boomy's on the free kick. Tom's on the free kick. Steve's on the free kick. I'd fancy Boomy for this one, but let's just wait and see. We've got PPR setting up the wall there. Referee's blowing his whistle. He's going to pull it. Is it Steve? I've seen that technique on Leroy Sané. Just a bit too much height on it. The whip was correct, but the height was a bit too much. I believe that is halftime. RB3, PPR 0. This is a great response from last week. The boys are not keeping it to the last minute to get the winner. We're going out hungry and looking for the win. Let's get into the halftime tea talk and see what Gaffmas has to say.
Fantastic football. But that all happened because, look, every single one of you guys, out of breath. You worked your socks off in that first 45 minutes. But I'm going to make that clear, first 45 minutes. I don't want deja vu of 3 weeks ago in Paddington Rec when we're 6-0 up and it becomes 6-4. So because of that, you've got another team target. Within the next 15 minutes, I need the next goal. Minimum. Everyone understood? Okay? 15 minutes. One goal minimum. Then we can start talking about other things. Okay? What you done, superb. Midfield battle. Where today, it was literally, you're hooking them up into the quadrants that I always talk about, in the corners. Then we've got, we're blessed with pace, blessed with pace, blessed with pace, blessed with pace. Even wide areas, superb. Kevin, well done. Great talking, great, talking from the back, seeing things. Now distribution. All right, with the wind, the ball is going to travel more. Up top, absolute nuisance. Well done, whoever it was. Shots on target, three goals. I'm seeing something's walking, crawling. Sorry, boys. All right, three shots. Great finishes. Daniel Berry in the first one. Second one, poacher's goal from a corner. Great delivery. And then third one, what a strike. So we've scored three weldies, okay, that we've deserved. Even over the last couple of weeks that haven't gone in, they've now gone in one game. That's how football works. But that's like I said, 45 minutes, we're going to make one change. Bilal, you're going to have a rest, okay? Yusuf, you're going to go in the 10, okay? Understood? Okay, apart from that, boys, really, really good.
Second half kicking off. Hopefully PPR can make this into a contest because it's not looking good right now. We got RB kicking off, but PPR do win back possession. Got Abdullah throwing it into Yusuf. Was he pushing it back? Refs called it. We've got Yusuf standing over the free kick, but I reckon from this angle, a lot of us would fancy maybe Abdullah on the whip back post or Steve to pull the trigger here. And just like I said, Steve's on the free kick. The question is, will he drill it back post or will he pull the trigger? Keeper's very close to his near post. He's setting up again. I reckon Steve's going to pull the trigger on this one. He does pull the trigger. Far post! That is ridiculous. The technique on that go back and watch Leroy Sané. Just type it on Google, Leroy Sané highlights free kick. That is the exact technique. Steve, great introduction to the RB team. Scores our fourth goal of the game. That's RB 4, PPR 0. And we do need a reaction from PPR because right now it's a mauling. Personally, I do blame the fact that they've only allowed a two-man wall. I feel like that's a poor decision from the keeper. He does control the wall after all, but as T1 would say, some say not a lot of keepers would save that one. Number 8 trying to make things happen. Getting run down by Bumi. Picks up the ball, sprays it out wide. What can Yunus do from this wide position? We've got a square that pass there. It does get cut out. That's great defending from PPR, to be fair to them. Haven't let their heads drop at all. He's going to get the clearance off. Instead, he's going to try to play out. 14's on the ball. Plays wide. He's a silver fox. Look at the experience on him. He's going to play line. He won't. He's holding it up. Bumi pressing on his own. We've got Brixton on the press right now. That's Bumi and Tom pressing right now. Some calling the Brixton bullies. That's a great back heel. He's going to run it off. They're calling for the offside. They're begging for the offside. One-on-one. Near post. Pure vim. That's Tom. One-on-one with the keeper. Was it going to end any other way? We've got the guy in the hood behind the keeper. Trying to give him constructive criticism. That is just down to poor mentality. Look at number 2. Just watch number 2 from PPR. No desire to get back at all. And I do believe that is a dagger in their heart. They are done this game. It's 5-0. We've got 54 minutes on the clock. And I feel like this could be really, really bad for them. If they don't change their attitude and try to get back in the game. Silver Fox on the ball. Trying to pick out a long one. Trying to pick out a worldie. Number 10 contested with Steve. Great touch from Steve. Plays it forward. Bumi asking for it out wide. Just skips past him with ease. Left pegs. Is he slotting it in behind? He is. He's setting it for Yusuf in behind. Is he going to pull the trigger? He squares it instead. I cannot believe that's gone in. The keeper made no effort there. It's great decision making from Yusuf. He could have taken it down and drove towards the keeper. Instead, squares it. And a near post header from Troy. It's just finished him off. I don't really know what to say. I just don't know what to say at this point. It's 6-0. 56 minutes played. And I believe, yeah, guys, in the comments, I know you're going to say the competition, this and this. We can only play what's in front of us. This is in our league, and we have to make things work with what we have in front of us. They did come first 10 minutes, first 20 minutes. They were ready. They seem up for the game, but the quality difference is very evident. RB came here with a game plan. Win the game, go home, and that's the game plan we're following. We've got PPR on the ball. Silver Fox looking in towards number 8. He picks up. He's going to play him in behind. He does, in fact, set the Silver Fox in behind. He's going to get the square off. He's not because he gets blocked out. I believe that was Hamdan on the block. We're just trying to keep a clean sheet. That's all that's important right now. Defensive threats not really there from PPR, but nonetheless, the boys are keeping a good mentality, going for the kill regardless. They got a corner coming in. Safe hands from Kevin. He's going to look forward for the counter. He will. Sprays it over the top. That's Yunus one-on-one with the keeper. It's not, in fact. We've got Yunus on the ball in the middle, though. PPR winning back. I think Yusuf slipped there. Silver Fox making a run out wide. He's going to get the ball off to him. No, he won't. He's been hunted down from the boys at RB. They're going to play it back. Just retain possession. Hamdan looking to spray it into midfield. Does anyone pick it up? No, I think PPR picked out. But we run it back again. That's Troy with a flick on. Yunus 1-on-1. Will he volley? No, he won't. He'll take it on his right foot. Great composure there. 1-on-1. Could have pulled the trigger on the volley. Takes it down. Just a little shift. No delay. 17's been absolutely left for dead. His keeper's been packed in. That is 7-0 to RB. At this point, I would have pressed options and rage quit, but PPR is still in the game. Unfortunately for the RB, the quality they're playing against is not something that's going to test them and push the boys to perform their very best, but you have to commend the mentality. They keep going, they keep hunting for goals. They don't care that PPR aren't really contesting them. They don't mind. Tom, just remind them that they do need that David Lloyd membership. The Revy's in. Number 5's made a merit that he's 1-on-1. He pulls the trigger, and he does indeed score. Rising Ballers' 8th goal of the game. That's Troy again. He was 1-on-1, guys. It's getting boring. I've been telling you. Troy 1-on-1. The story only ends one way. Keeper a bit hesitant there. Could have made himself a bit bigger, but at this point, I don't blame him. His head's probably down in the dumps. And it's going to be a tough game for them to reflect on. We've got 8-0 to the RB. Trying to make things happen. PPR on the attack. They play it wide. It's not the Silver Fox this time. Instead, he's cutting back. 1-on-1 with Abdullah. Showing him a bit of steps. Cuts it in. Cuts it back out. Gets the crossing in the end, to be fair to him. And some say that should have been their goal. That would have been a bit of consolation for them to get something out of this game, because apart from that, it's been a poor display from them. We've got Yusuf 1-on-1 with the goalkeeper. Left pegs. Keeper does manage to make a save, to be fair to him. Josh on the edge of the box gets fouled there. Bought that foul. Referee's not hearing it, though. PPR trying to make things happen. No, they aren't. We've got RB picking a ball in the midfield again. I do believe that's Josh, the famous left pegs. He's going to square the ball. He will square the ball. Eunice on the square right now. Yusuf trying to make things happen. Unfortunately, headers it just over the crossbar. 69 minutes played. 8-0 to the RB. Kevin with a long ball over the top. Where is that one dropping? He's dropping dead in front of the goalkeeper. That's a great hit from Kevin. And Yusuf cannot reward him for his efforts, unfortunately. I would back Yusuf in any situation. If someone told me £101,000, I'd put Yusuf's name up there. But unfortunately, he hasn't been able to put that one away. PPR, did they wake up on the wrong side of the bed? Were they just tactically outclassed by Gaffer Maz? We've got a Megs from Bumi. Forget what I was saying. Number two, you got to close though. He's not setting a good example. Yusuf one-on-one with the keeper. Will it be right foot? Will it be left foot? No, it won't. It'll be going around the keeper. Bumi asking for the square. He won't get it though. Smiles all over the pitch as Yusuf does put that one in the net for RB's ninth goal of the game. 78 minutes played. Rising ball is 9. PPR, 0. No consolation for them so far. Yusuf showing great composure. Just knocked that one around the keeper. And does have the composure to put that one in the net. Ice cold, veins freezing.
You know why? Because I got in his head, I said you only score penalties, you don't score from open play. I what? Penalties only!
RB on the ball, Josh is on the edge trying to make things happen. Flicks and tricks, does a bit too much there, he's been caught out twice. Number 9 trying to take the drive, but he can't seem to do it. Hamdan setting the ball to feet, Steve just composed on it. We've got Jeffrey in the ball, he's going to play across the back. Josh asking for it. Nobbling and bobbling to his feet, but he does get there in the end. Will he play keeper? No, he won't. He'll play it left instead. Jeffrey's going to go home. No, he won't. He'll play it line instead. Boom, he's flicked that around him and managed to. Is he running back on the other side? Number 4 setting him back to his keeper. You've got Yusuf on the press. Will the keeper get the clearance off? Only clearing it as far as Boomy. Is he going to shift it and shoot? That's the signature Boomy. No, he won't. Slides in Bilal instead. He's going to look for the square. He does square it in the end. Pulls the trigger on the edge of the box, and that is a great finish. Debatably one of the best finishes we've had this game. Danny Berry picking a corner on his return to the RB. He's got 2 on the score sheet. What a player he is, to be fair. Great skill, great composure, and that is a great finish. Inside of the boot, that's another goal. That's 10-0 to the RB. 10-0 to the RB. 84 minutes played. 50-50 there. Number 3 is not backing out of those. Eunice on his first touch. Second touch. Beats the player. Is taken out there. Will he bring it back? No, he won't. Because a 1-on-1. And we'll score our 11th goal. No, we haven't scored our 11th goal. Because the linesman deemed that offside. Tell me how number 7 was beaten for pace. RB's player is running from in behind him. And he's still been deemed offside. But it's that moment. Bumi's on the free kick. I think I know how this one's going to end. Great save from the keeper. Showing a never say die attitude. Bumi's a bit dismayed that of all the shots that have gone in, he's managed to save that one. But we got RB in the ball. Steve taking a short one. Josh 1v1 with the Silver Fox. Can he beat him? Is he cunning enough? He is, in fact. Great ball roll from Steve. Is he going to pull the trigger? He's on the edge. Fake shot, right foot. And that's just gone over the bar. Great display of skill from Steve here. Just a little ball roll to knock it past. Silver Fox has given up. From here, you think he's going to put it on his left? In fact, he will not. Just to let you defenders know, you lot have been bumped. You paid £4 for 2 litre milk from Iceland that went off yesterday. So you lot better go back and get your refunds. We've got Kevin outside the box, looking for one in behind. He knocks it, entering the final third. Josh is contesting and does manage to get it down. He's going to play it wide. Bumi asking for the ball in behind. Is he going to get the ball? No, Daniel's going to cut in on the left peg for his hat-trick. And he does get the hat-trick in the end. I've said it once, I've said it twice. I'm saying it for the third time. Daniel Berry, what a player. Just a fake out number 17. Pull it on his left foot instead. Great composure, great finish. That's the 11th goal of the game. And that is full-time. We've got Rising Ballers 11, Powerpuff Rangers 0. It was not their day, it was our day instead. Great debut from Steve, a great return from Daniel Berry, and this is a great way to go into our next game. Great mentality from the boys, great performance. It's been your boy LB, aka Mac of Adelele, aka What a Player. And I'll see you guys next week.
Hi, what a free kick. Whoa, you turned out yourself, eh? Eh?
Nothing, man.
Yusuf, how many? How many?
Just two today.
Hey, what was your... Come here. What was your score prediction?
I said 10. I said 10, we got 12.
I said Daniel Berry's back with a hat-trick. He said before the game a hat-trick, you know. Did you score 4? He's got a hat-trick.
I should have scored 4, but the guy said offside.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah, he scored 3. Just like...
That's for everyone. Absolutely fantastic out there. Okay? Superb. I'll stand on the sidelines to the point where we're having laughs and jokes and enjoying the football on show, the goals, the clever touches, the assists, some of the misses, okay, the desperation. But it was part of the game. We made it fun.
That's how every game should be for Rising Ball. It should be fun. Yes, we're there to win, and we're there to you know, put out a statement, how we've done today. But the most important thing is, you need to have fun when you're playing football, otherwise you don't enjoy it. You need to have fun. You lot train Monday to Friday, all right, working hard. So it shows on the pitch on a Saturday, but the most important thing, like I said, is fun. When you enjoy your football, all right, and you're having fun, that's when, you know, class things come out, both individually and collectively. Superb. I'm going to end it on this. I shouldn't have to make team targets for you guys to meet them. I shouldn't have to. It should already be there. But because I am a coach and I look like around the group and I need to do it at the moment, so be it. No problem. I will do it. But it needs to come from within as well. Okay, boys? Yeah. Apart from that, superb. My MOM, all right, I'll be honest with you. It was out of you, superb, and you, superb. If you didn't score, but you ran everywhere. Okay? Who are we going for?
Steve.
We're going Steve. Hey!
Tom and Trey, the twins. I know which one's which, but you can guess below.
Come on, yes, boys!
Please, my twin.
Get out of the shop.
My
this is not.
Ayo,
this,
shut up, fam.
You know them clingy gal there, man? Move, man. You're too clingy, bro.
It's not for you.
We're going to boil me like that. Bait all YouTubers.
All right, Tom and Trey. Hat trick for Trey. Tom with a goal as well. Talk to us about the match.
Light game, you know, started off bright. Came with a game plan, you know, small pitch, no faffing about, and just playing out from the back from early, just send it long, nice and direct football, you know, got two goals nice and early, you know, that set us up nicely for the rest of the game. And then we, you know, came out second half and just absolutely battered them and finished them off.
You want to talk about your hat-trick?
Standard procedure. Come on, do your job. Go home, enjoy your weekend.
That's what we like to hear.
That's what I have to say.
All right, who's going to be top goal scorer this season?
Silly question. I don't answer silly questions.
All right, well played, boys. Yes, guys. Yusuf and debutant Steve. Talk to us about the game, first of all.
Nah, to be fair, it was an easy game. Like, obviously, we stuck to the game plan, scored the goals that we had to score, and just done our thing, basically, yeah.
So, obviously, Steve, new player. I know him very well. Class performance today. Absolute world. You have a free kick. Obviously, as a team, play really, really well today. What's that? 11 goals did we get?
Nah, 12.
12 goals. Yeah. Happy with the team performance. Maz is happy. And yeah, we've done our jobs today.
We all happy as well. Agent signing on for you.
Yeah. I'm his agent for now.
My player. No way. No way.
Well, yeah, Yusuf, how many goals did you get?
Today I got two, so that's five in the league, in three games. So obviously, more to come.
We're going to see more assists from Steve.
Yeah.
We're going to see more assists from Steve to Yusuf, yeah?
Of course, that link up on the left side is more headers than, yeah.
Well played.
Got my midfielder, he played in the 10 dog, all right. 9K he's completed, so better than a community player. You're not a community player, all right. Slightly off a pro player, all right? But if we're talking about, once again, the intensity and the players he's around, all right? He didn't have to do that much because a lot of it was play, move. So in terms of the running, very, very good. However, first half, as you can see, look at his heat map, makes sense. Look at his heat map in the second half, all right? And there we are. Look, improvement in the second half, 26% final third entries compared to 10% in the first half. A decent high speed running, score or 674. My high flying wing back, very, very quick. Total distance, 10.76, 8.28. So he's not quite the Reece James levels, all right? But it's week one, game one, not bad at all. In terms of these boys, let me see Yusuf as well. Distance covered. Oh, he's played 45 minutes, 5.7K. I'll take that, I'll take that. So look, that's decent work. Week one done, game one done. Yeah, I'm very, very happy, but levels need to get higher. Go get your StatSports tracker and see how you get on. Love.